wars we wage.
I'm Jill, and I'm hanging out with the dudes from Crash Parallel. Guys, self-intro.
How you doing? I'm Tim from Crash Parallel.
And I am Dan from Crash Parallel.
So, you guys have your debut album coming out really soon. Yep. Are you excited about that?
Yeah, really excited. We've been working on it for a long time, so for us, it's kind of like a nice weight off your shoulders to be able to now go out and promote a record that you've been, you know, proud of and waiting for a long time. So we're definitely excited.
So you guys sound a lot, in my opinion, like Counting Crows. I'm sure you guys hear a lot of comparisons. Yeah. Who do you think you guys, like, who are you influenced by?
I'm influenced by, I guess from a lyrical perspective, I've always wanted to tell stories. I think Adam Duritz from the Counting Crows does the same thing. It's part of the reason for the comparison. I tend to whine a little when I'm trying to reach those high notes. That's probably another reason. But, you know, I've listened to the Counting Crows. But Pearl Jam was one of mine growing up. David Gray has been an influence on me.
Pearl Jam as well is a big one for me. Even newer bands. Coldplay, I guess, sonically, melodically.
Are you worried about comparisons? Like, people might think you're some kind of like knockoff of The Fray or Coldplay or something like that?
No, I think everybody's idea, the brain tends to want to find something to compare to, no matter what. You know, whether it's in a relationship, you compare yourself to the last girlfriend or, you know, blah, blah, blah. I think people want that, and that's why it exists, is so that you can put someone in a place where their expectation is. I'm not afraid of it because I don't believe it sounds like any one of those bands. If you wanted to draw a square, and you probably put us right in the middle of four of those bands that we mentioned. But I think the other thing was that, for me, some of the music sounded like some other bands. Maybe you could compare it to that. The singing sounded like something else, you know. So it's kind of like, I don't know, for me, it came from inside, and, you know, maybe it came from some of the influences. But it doesn't really hurt my feelings if people compare it to things, because I think we're proud of it, and we think it's unique and original.
We know we weren't trying to chase any type of sound as well when we're writing this stuff, so.
So what are some of your long-term goals for the band? Because I know you guys are just kind of starting off. Mm-hmm. So where do you see yourselves?
Songwriting, definitely something we always want to do. We talked about that when we started this project. But we want to be a career band. We want to tour, and we want to put out six more records.
As far as we can go.
Absolutely.
Reach as many people as possible.
And we feel like it's the beginning of what we're trying to create. Like, it's a first record, so, you know, even with comparisons, we're going to change. We're going to learn more about our instruments. The live show is going to change how we do our next record. I think, you know, all those things have an influence, so it's exciting.
I feel like there were a lot of heartbreak songs on the album. Were you guys heartbroken when you wrote it?
Definitely half the songs had probably, there was like a nice low time there where definitely with some heartbreaks. But, you know, the cool thing about heartbreak is you go through the phases of like where you're down and really depressed, and you go through the phases where, you know, you're coming out of it. And those are all great things to draw from when you're writing a song. So.
Songwriting is kind of a form of therapy too, right? So.
Absolutely, for us, it definitely is.
So you guys, did you meet in high school, or?
Yeah. Near the end of high school we met. Yeah. He was in another band at the time, I think, and I used to see him play, and then I would play. After or before in another band. Then we ended up being in the same band and kind of grew from there.
Was it you that was really heavily influenced by hip-hop and then you had no interest in rock at all?
Yeah. It was actually just after the time when we played in the band. It was a punk band. Tim was actually the drummer.
Punk band, nice.
Yeah, and it ended kind of not in the best way with the other guys, not with Tim and I. So I kind of got sick of rock music. I started producing hip-hop and house music, and learned how to do, you know, all the studio stuff and kind of the do-it-yourself thing. And a few years later, I heard that Tim had some kind of acoustic tracks he'd written, wanted some help with, so we reconnected, and yeah.
Yeah, there's probably no one I worked with throughout any of that time that I would have gone, because I was the same way. I went to film school, I'm like, forget music, you know? Yeah. just because, you know, it's hard to collaborate with people, but Dan was someone I always got along with, and was probably the one person that could have made this happen, and he did. He helped make Crash Parallels.